Hello everybody and welcome to Universe Sandbox 2 with me and my buddy Chris.
Hello there.
Chris is going to be helping me sort of build a solar system.
Even though I can't see, but I can still help.
Well, you're going to help me by naming stuff. So we're going to pick a let's pick a nice big-ish star. Let's go for this one. It's called Arcturus, but we're going to obviously name it something else. So there we go. We have a star. What are we going to call it, Chris? What is the center of the universe? What is the center of our solar system going to be called? How about Alan?
Yes. Alan.
Alan. Right, our star is now called Alan.
Shit.
And its surface temperature is 4,290 degrees.
So, why did you make it Alan's number?
Oh, what? Like, oh yeah, okay. Alan 08606. Okay, there you go. So now we've got a star called Alan 08626. In the constellation DDJP. I guess. Penis. Anywho, shall we build a planet first then, Chris?
Yes.
A random rock planet. So, I don't know how... The problem is I need to actually measure how far a planet actually is from its sun in order... So we're going to put this one quite close and put it into orbit around it. Because I want to gauge the temperature because I'd like to have an exoplanet at some point.
That's fair. Suddenly Alan sucked it in.
Oh god, that happened to me this morning. It was bizarre. I'm doing it basically. I'm doing, as I was saying to Chris earlier on, I'm doing a recording session this morning, and I had a star, and I had a planet called Alan, hence why the star is called Alan. And the planet literally just ate everything else and turned into a super gas giant, even the sun of the solar system. Right, so the surface temperature this far away from the sun is actually at -26.
Ooh,
so that's a bit cold for an exoplanet, don't you think? Because I want a planet with water on it. So we're going to delete this object. And, oh god.
Delete this.
We're going to put a random rock planet a bit closer then this time. Oh god. So I've got to move closer to... Oh my god. This game is so random to try and control. So let's put that there. I don't know what that... Oh my god, hang on. If I click on Alan, the planet, then I'll be able to see this. Not the planet, the star. So if I click this one, what's the temperature on this one? 35 degrees. So where we are now, where this planet is right now, is about where we want our exoplanet. So if we put an exoplanet down a little bit closer and a bit further over and on a slightly different angle, that's our exoplanet. So if I delete that one.
And then add slightly too much cocaine to the mix.
No.
Aww.
Oh god, hang on, what the hell? Oh, it's a gas... Oh god, it's a gas giant, I think. Right, we don't want that one. I just want to set up a template, because in future, I want to know what I can and can't do. So, exoplanet, we want about here. Right, here we go. I think this is more what we want. It's quite small, though. It has an atmosphere, I think. Right, anyway, whatever. We're gonna leave the planet here, because it's... Let's see. Its surface temperature is 60 degrees. So quite a warm planet then. So what are we going to call this planet then, Chris?
Teapot.
No, let's not call it teapot.
Shit.
Let's not call it teapot. Well, actually, I like the idea of calling it Rasmus. I like that name.
Oh, thank you.
But we're going to give it a number. So what's the number of Buckleby Grange? It's like 6802, isn't it?
6803.
6803. So we've got Rasmus 6803.
Shit, now you give me the great name for it. Oh, fuck you, Tom.
What have I given you?
Well, considering I'm starting my own series, now I know what they're going to call Buckleberry.
You're going to call it Rasmus?
Yes.
Okay, that's totally big-headed, but okay, fine, geez.
Hey, listen, my head is massive.
We know.
Like, the chairman ain't got nothing on.
So that's why this planet is a bit like it is. I want to add some... Oh, God, no hydrogen. Let's bring down the amount of liquid it has. Let's bring the liquid to be about... I want it to have a little bit of liquid, but not, like, too much. That's a bit of liquid. Great, we'll put a bit of hydrogen as well. Can I sort...
You figured out how to do that stuff, then?
Sort of, yeah. The only thing is, I'm not sure if I... There was a... here we go, atmosphere. I can change the amount of atmosphere it has and everything. I'm not sure whether it works though sometimes. No, it doesn't work properly sometimes. I think it depends on what the composition of your planet is.
Ah.
So if I make if I give it a bit more iron, a little less, give it a proper mantle, a bit more water and a bit more hydrogen. And then I think we can edit the atmosphere now. No. Surface pressure 2. Here we go. Surface pressure, if I make that about 40, that gives us a proper atmosphere then.
Nice.
Greenhouse effect 30. We're going to make this planet warm up a little bit. Oh, no, it's cooling down a bit. That's good. The surface temperature going down. So Rasmus 6803 is orbiting Alan. So now it needs a moon. Or several moons. So let's go for a random moon. We're going to stick him in orbit around Rasmus. Not too far. Well, about 37,000 kilometres.
That works.
Right, so what are we going to call this moon then, Chris, seeing as it's your moon?
Phil.
Phil?
Yes.
As in P-H-I-L?
Yes.
Right, okay, your moon is called Phil. Okay, your first moon is called Phil. I literally can't believe that was in the same sentence, but your moon is called Phil. What colour would you like your moon to be?
Wait, I get to choose colour as well?
You can change the colour of your moon, yeah.
What's that? Like orangey, you know that, like, dance... Like Mars, kind of, but more orange.
Okay, like an orangey-red, then. You want your moon to be an orangey-red. Okay. Here we go. Actually, that looks about what we want it to be, actually. There we go. So, Phil is a brown moon.
Yes.
What composition are we going to give it?
That's up to you, because I have no idea what that means.
Composition is like iron, silicate, water, and hydrogen. Like, what, basically, it's made of. Is it made of more... Is it a rocky moon? Is it going to have water on it, or what? If we add water, it sort of freezes it a little bit, though.
Hydrogen, I'd say, actually.
Oh god, that makes it a gas. That makes it all gassy, though. We'll add a little bit of hydrogen, because if you get to a certain point, it makes it pop. Yeah,
say if I, boom.
Yeah, literally. When you watch the video back, you'll see like the planet starts to sort of has gas coming off it.
Yeah, I can't see shit that Tom's doing. I'll have to watch this back later to see what's happening.
You'll enjoy it, Chris. You'll enjoy watching your planet have a moon circulating around it.
Called Phil.
Called Phil. Right, we're going to do a second moon. We're going to do a bigger moon now. And we're going to have it inclined at a different angle. So what we're going to call this one?
You're going to hate me.
Okay.
Collins.
Oh, Chris. Okay. Oh, mate. Okay. Is that with two L's or what?
Hang on, let me check.
I think it's two L's.
So yeah, it's two L's.
You got Phil and Collins.
Alright, just saying, I've been blaring Phil Collins and Genesis all day today, so,
I've made Collins slightly bigger than, Phil, because... What colour do you want what do you want Collins to look like?
How about a greenish tint?
Okay. A greeny-coloured planet. Okay.
Yeah, it's a greeny-weeny.
Well, not greeny planet, a greeny, oh god, that looks bizarre. We need to make the whole planet a bit more green. Oh god, that looks really weird. A green planet is weird. So green and black. There you go. So you got Phil and Collins. I need to sort out your planet though, because I want to give it a spin. Like, I want to give it a rotation. 95 days. Let's make that something like 60 hours. You can't really see it very well, but the planet... You can't really see the planet spinning, actually, because it's... Oh, yeah, you can see it a little bit. So, Rasmus 6803 is currently orbiting Alan 606 with two men called Phil and Collins.
Ah, I love being a funny fuck.
And yet, because you've got Phil on a sort of a plain flat rotation, you've got Collins is sort of doing its own thing. So, if I increase CU simulation speed a little bit... You should be able to see it in a minute. Hold on. Increase the simulation speed a little bit more. There we go. You can see that Phil is sort of just rotating, like swooping around, and Collins is going up and down a little bit. So what else should we add to this? Anything in particular you want me to add around Rasmus 6803, or we're going to leave it at that?
I think we're going to leave it at that.
Okay. Let's go to the surface and just... Well, not surface. I wanted to see where we could see the shadows of the moons. You'll be able to see it when Phil comes around again.
Yeah, and if you listen carefully, you might hear the sounds of Canterbury Love.
You will not, young lady. Oh, God, what's that? Oh, wait, that's Collins coming around the other way.
No.
Collins is passing over and up from the planet. You see, I know this sounds really weird, Chris, but I actually really like this random stuff that I can do.
Yeah, no, it's great. It's so great, isn't it? Just to have a computer and the Steam sale.
I literally just saw the shadow of Phil cross this planet of Rasmus. Right, so we're going to leave them well alone. So what I'm going to do, just to make sure that I can, I'm going to save this system as DDJPS01. Just so that if there's any cock-ups, we get back to this point. So, for example, if I were to launch an asteroid at your planet, then I would be able to come back to this point.
Shit.
Right, so we know roughly where an exoplanet can orbit and be a safe-ish sort of distance and temperature. So let's put a rock planet in, I guess, next.
Go for it.
Right, and then we'll move that in a bit closer and make it really hot. So here we go. And now we've got to think of a name for this one, Chris. What do we call this little planet?
I already have one in mind.
Oh, God, go on.
All right, so it's
F44422. Okay, Fowler.
Yeah, there you go.
Fowler. Wait, what? Fowler 4422?
Well, that's his LMS number.
Okay, let's add number 4 then. So F44442. There! So, because of the Fowler 4F being 4 Fs, we're now going to have to make the planet a bit black.
Yes.
And rocky. High elevation, we're going to make, I don't know, a freaking orangey colour, I guess. Mm-hmm. And then mid elevation, about a dark orange, I guess. Like a brown. There we go. So that is F44422.
Yes.
And that is rotating. I'm going to make that rotate quite a bit because of the gravitational pull. Hours. It doesn't take 6,000 hours. It's going to take 624 hours to rotate. And it's rotating weirdly.
Uh-oh. Oh, shit, Tom.
Hey, up. What?
I've just gotten an email.
Have you?
It's about my apprenticeship.
Oh, no. That doesn't help me in the slightest.
Oh, shit!
What?
I might actually get taken up, dude.
Oh, wow. How amazing and interesting, too.
Yeah, that means I actually have a job after this.
What? I don't know what's going on with my thing. Chris, help me. I don't know what's going on with my... I think...
Well, I can't see.
Hang on, wait. I think I know what's happened. I've got to delete Fowler.
Oh. Sorry, Anthony. Your series isn't good enough.
Well, it's not that. It's just that I didn't put it into a proper rotation, so we'll try again.
Ah, fair point. Also, while you're doing this, I'm just digging into a tub of ice cream.
Because you, Chris, are very fat.
You are correct.
What has happened? Oh, God, no. Dude, your moons have ruined themselves. Hang on, Ned. Hang on. We can salvage this.
Have they crashed?
No, they haven't crashed. It's just they've come out of... I don't know, by doing whatever I did, I ruined the rotational thingamajigger.
Okay, because I was going to say, well, if they crashed, they made Phil Collins.
So what I've done is just sped up the thing so you can see roughly what the hell your planet is doing. So if we come around to Rasmus, oh my God, you can just see it's like a corkscrew.
Uh-huh.
Like, you got one planet, you got one corp going round, and the other one just sort of doing its own thing, going around in a random ellipse.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, let's slow this back down again. Because we need to now attempt... Yeah, you can see it's rotating around. We need to attempt to stick something else around Alan. So we're going to try the Fowler again. But we're going to put it closer still and have it rotating the other, like, round a different way. Like, it's going to be going round the planet, round the sun even, like, how can I explain? Like, on a different axis?
Yeah.
Like, it's not going, like, round and round and round. It's going round a different way. So what we're going to call this one? It's F-222-4422. F-444-22.
Yes.
Right, here we go. Hello, F-4422. You are a planet, apparently.
Shouting out to all our friends.
We don't have friends, Chris. Remember that? Do you remember that?
You don't have to remind me, man.
Right, we're going to make it quite a... It's a siliconate planet. If I put hydrogen on it, it sort of starts burning up.
Oh, cheeky.
What about water? Oh, water makes it a, Oh, God, no. Oh, my God, what the hell just happened? There we go. Now we've got a planet with some actual water on it, I think. Oh, hang on. We had water for a second. Oh, I know why, because the planet's too hot. Because it's not the right distance away from, the star. Because the surface temperature is like 384 degrees.
Oh, jeez.
So, okay, we're going to leave F-4422. We're going to give it a moon.
Oh, jeez, Rick.
Oh, jeez, Rick! We're going to give it the tiniest little moon that has ever existed. Oh, that's God, Jesus Christ. Look at that. Look at its rotation period. What is its rotation period, actually? What are we going to call this one? Oh, we're going to call this one Felix.
Yes.
Don't ask me for its bloody number. I wouldn't be able to tell you.
Me neither.
Its rotation period... No, its orbital period is 1 day. So it takes an entire day to... Yeah, it takes a day... Felix takes a day to rotate around F-44422.
Oh.
Is that quite interesting, I guess?
That sounds very familiar to something.
Yeah, it does. Right, so what are we going to do with Felix then? What are we going to make this made out of, I guess? It's a rocky planet, so we want to give it lots of rock. Like silicon. Do we want to try water? Or the water just burns straight off. So no water. A little bit of hydrogen. Oh my God, some hydrogen in the core makes it a fat moon. But the moon is actually steaming because of it being so close to the sun, to the star.
Okay.
So you can see, so I'm going to give it no hydrogen and no water. There we go.
Alright, this is the 7th time I've uploaded this fucking video, I swear to God.
God, this system is already looking quite bizarre. If I click on Alan and then move out, you got Rasmus and F-4422 just randomly... If I speed up the simulation a bit, I don't think I can speed it up too much. Because the problem is, if I do that, it starts screwing up the simulation a bit.
It's only timing a million miles an hour.
Okay, so F-4422. If I click on it, I'm just going to get F-4422. Oh, God. You look at the moon, it's just going mental.
Oh, no.
The moon is just going round and round. So if I click on Rasmus, what's going on with Finn and Collins then?
Now then.
They are rotating quite smoothly around the planet, so that's good. So we're going to add any more... Do you reckon we should add another moon to F-4422? Or do you reckon we should leave it with just one?
I think we should just leave it on one. On the extra. I don't know.
We'll leave it with one. So what I'm going to do is save this. Oh, go back to the start. Save. Oh, God. What did I say? DDJPS. Oh, hang on. S01. And yes, I would like to override the old one. Thank you very much. So if I bring this down a little bit. Right, now what? I guess we need a gas giant now, don't we?
That sounds right.
James Wright.
Hey.
So let's put the gas giant around. Let's put it sort of. I'm trying to think where we could put it. I want to put it between the two orbits of the other two planets, basically. And we're going to have it like that. There we go. Right, well, who do we know that's full of hot air? James Wright. So we're going to call this planet Righty J.
Righty J.
So what we're going to do to this one, we are going to give it a lot of hydrogen and a lot of water and hydrogen, hardly anything else in the core. We're going to give it a bit of mass, not mass, radius. We're going to make it about, oh, that makes it really small. We don't want that. We want to add an extra zero to the end of that. There we go. Righty J, full of gas, between F4422. Oh god, Chris, what are we doing? What are we doing?
What are you doing?
So they want to mess with the motion, or the composition even. Okay. So we need to add a moon, I guess, or something. In fact, should we add something different? Should we add something like a random asteroid?
Yes.
I think Righty J should have a lot of moons, though, because he doesn't have a lot of followers, and we think we should give him some.
Aww, shots fired.
Aw, shucks. Oh, Jesus. Okay, the rotation. The hours? Oh, my God. How much does this go round, then? Hang on, let's look at its overview. Its orbital period is 18 hours around Righty J.
Jeez.
And it's essentially, it's melting, essentially, this rock. So what are we going to call this one?
How about... Ooh.
Ooh, okay.
For fuck's sake, Tom.
Right, we have an asteroid called Ooh.
Right. Sorry, James.
Right, okay. We want to give it a radius of about... We want to make it quite a... Oh, it turns itself into a planet if we make it any bigger than that. Okay, so let's make it 55 then.
Cheeky.
So we have a little thing called Ooh doing a very strange orbit around. It's doing a very strange orbit around Righty J. It's not even technically orbiting it. I've got a feeling it's going to crash into it at some point.
Cheeky breaky.
So let's go for a big moon and let's make it a bit further away and on a different axis plane. What are we going to call this one then? What does James like? Oh, I know. LNER sucks. And we're going to paint it in the superior southern malachite green. What do you think, Chris? Good idea? No? Yeah? Maybe so?
Yes. Southern malachite green.
Oh.
Wait, what?
Rude. And then yellow because for the sunshine yellow.
Hang on, there's a wasp in my room. So...
Oh god, not again. Not a wasp, Chris. Not a wasp. Sorry. Again. Yeah. Oh no, it's going to eat you. You know that. Okay, it's a bit rude. I think it's a bit rude to call it LNR sucks. We're just going to put it... We're just going to call it...
UWR owns?
I don't know. Let's just call it... I'm going to call it Beta Wax because it looks like earwax. What is going on with that ooh thing? It's just literally burning off loads of gas.
Right, the wasp is out. I'm safe to proceed.
Cool. Right, so we've got a planet. We've got a moon around Righty J called Betawax. We're going to get a clone of Titan. And we're going to call it Not Titan.
You're going to call it Not Titan?
Yeah, we're going to call it Not Titan. That is its name. It's called Not Titan. And in composition, we're going to give it a hell of a lot more gas and a hell of a lot more water.
Gas, 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 got to step on the gas.
No. I think what we're also going to do with it is increase its mass. Well, make its radius about... Let's make it really big. Holy shit. That moon is almost as big as Lighty J itself. So that should make it a bit less than that. Let's give it a density of about 400 odd. There we go. So if we speed up the simulation ever so slightly, just to see what it does in comparison to... Oh, right, okay, it is sort of... It is orbiting, it's just going around in a random way. I'm pretty sure that, ooh, we're going to crash into Righty J at some point, no, Chris?
Good.
Because ooh is very close. So I'm gonna get another we're just adding loads of moon to this one, I think.
Alright, so add another moon.
Yeah, we're adding another moon. What are we gonna call this one?
Alright, so let's think of something James doesn't have. So let's see. Friends, subscribers, love what?
I don't know. I don't know. What should we call it? Fudge, help. How about Jim?
Sure. Let's fucking call it Jim.
Right, okay, we've got a moon called Jim. And he's going to be made of, he's going to have made a little bit of water, a little bit of hydrogen.
A little bit of cum. Wait, what?
Yeah, a little bit of hydrogen, and we're going to give him a lot of, quite a fair chunk in there. We're going to make him a little bit bigger than he already is. Apparently his surface temperature is like minus? Why is it minus? Oh yeah, something I'm going to do to not Titan. I'm going to change its colour. So it doesn't look like Titan. Oh, hang on, wait. You're joking. I can't actually change it. Oh, I can't change it colour. Oh, okay. That's rude. Incredibly rude that is, Chris. I'm going to cry. Anyway, so not Titan is going around Righty J. We should really go and check on our other planets in a minute, shouldn't we?
We probably should before it's like, oh shit!
I don't know, because like, Righty J ain't going around quite alright at the moment, by the looks of it. Rasmus is over there, so let's go click on him. See what he's doing. Right, Phil and Collins. You'll be pleased to know Phil and Collins are still orbiting, by the looks of it. Okay? Happy with that?
I'm happy with that.
So what about Fowler 44422? Still being orbited by Felix as well. So I think it's time for another save, don't you? Because at the moment we've got we have three planets orbiting this system. F4422, Righty J, and Rasmus 6803. So that's a good start. Oh god. Problem is I have to keep right. You know what, I'm just gonna copy him. I'm gonna copy that for now.
You mean you have to keep
writing? I have to keep writing the same name, yeah. Oh, I think my other video needs to finish rendering, so I can upload that in a minute.
Take it.
So, I think it's time for another planet, I've got better there. How about we put another random asteroid in, just to fuck things up for everyone. and let's see if it can get attracted to the gravitational pull of Righty J rather than Alan. Actually, no, let's put it there. And put it in a similar orbit to Righty J. And we're going to call this one... I don't know. This one looks like it's about to screw things up for everyone. So we're going to call it... Ian Reilly. No, we're not. I'm not going to do that. I will call it Ian, though.
Yes. But it's in no shape, way, or form quoting to...
Any sort of thing that we may or may not joke about from time to time. I mean, clearly, Chris, yes. You got to understand. We understand this, don't we? This very important fact.
Yeah, we do. It's true facts.
Okay, cool. So Ian is very happily in orbit now. Wait, where is Righty J? Don't tell me I put this in the wrong orbit. Oh, mate, Righty J is like miles and like billions of miles away. Like, it's not even on the same orbit. It's ridiculous. It's like miles out.
You're such an idiot, Tom.
I know, but Rasmus is quite safe out where it is. Rasmus is like the furthest thing out at the moment, and it's probably the most safe place to be because I'm fucking things over for the inside. Same as I'm just going to put another random exoplanet in a bit closer and see what happens. God, you can see how it's... God, right, hang on. I want to put it a bit more flat. Oh, God. No. What is going on here? Said Thomas. Wait, hang on. I think I've got to click on Alan and then do it. Random exoplanet. Here we go. I know what it is. It's because of the gravitational pull of everything else.
Oh.
So we're going to put about, about there. Oh, Chris, I shit you not. It's called WASP and it's orange. So this exoplanet is going to be called WASP. I'm not really going to modify the name that much. I'm just going to swap over two letters. So it's WASP.
Damn, that's exactly what I should name one of my WASPs. They keep coming WASP in my room and flying a fuck.
Well, we've got a planet here called WASP. 3B.
Oh.
So it's got a 3B, this planet has.
Damn.
And it's also very hot. Apparently the surface temperature is 168 degrees.
Hmm.
Oh, wait, let's try and reset that. Let's make it minus. Right, there we go. And then we'll set that to be more neutral at about 20 degrees.
Hmm?
Right, there we go. So we've sorted out WASP. Oh, the temperature is going up. Composition. It's made out of completely gas, that's why.
Don't light a match or you're gonna die.
All way up. Oh, mate, this planet actually has some surface features.
Really?
Yeah, so I'm gonna not call it WASP, I'm gonna call it something else. I'm gonna call it, oh, you'll see it in the video anyway, but actually, should we just leave it as WASP 3B, actually?
Yeah, sure, why not?
No, I can't do that. I know exactly what to call this planet because it has life on it.
What?
Dave.
Hey.
So our planet is now called Dave. And because he's the safest planet from the sun, because his surface temperature is about 160 at the moment. So even though that's still pretty hot, to be fair, Dave the planet is about the right distance away from Alan to not be eaten. So actually, so in the spirit of things, we're going to call it Day 45101.
Yay!
And we're going to give it a moon called Hannah. How cheeky is that?
Too cheeky. Another one called Beer.
Oh, yeah! Yes! Chris, you mad genius!
So Hannah and Beer are the only two things spinning around.
No, what it should be is Hannah orbiting Dave, right? Mm-hmm. And then another one called Mr. Dark, because Mr. Dark's always buzzing around Dave, isn't he?
Oh, fuck yeah.
Right,
especially after you find those dirty magazines.
Yeah, exactly. Right, so that's that video, I think, done. Yeah, close. I will check on that shortly. Well, actually, no, I can't check on it shortly. I've got to start uploading it like right now. So we're going to look at Dave for a minute while I sort stuff out. I'll get back to the video once it's uploaded. I'm sure it won't take too long. I'm sure it'll be fine. But did you know, Chris?
I'm sure it'll be fine.
But did you know that eventually everyone runs out of time?
Yes, everybody does.
Cool.
It's a sad thing, but I accept it.
I just remember we weren't looking at Dave. We were looking at... What is it going to be called, Hannah? Hannah is his moon.
Hannah is mooning Dave.
Pretty much.
I mean, I don't think Dave is minding too much.
Probably not. So it's Hannah at 5930. So what is his composition? I guess it's... Oh, I don't know. Hang on. You know what? The weird thing is... Here we go, colour. We need it to sort of have a dark green undercolour. Oh, it hasn't really got much in the way of elevation, so green looks a bit weird. It needs to sort of be a rocky colour then. But with green highlights, I guess.
That works.
That looks a bit bizarre. There we go, that'll do. So we have Hannah 5930 orbiting Day 45101.
45101, hey!
And what do we say we're going to have another moon doing? Wait, hang on. First thing first, though, as this system is actually starting to look quite comprehensive and nice, Saving it.
Save it.
Save it.
Phrasing.
Because then what I can do later on is we can build this, and then right at the end we can fuck it all up and then have the knowledge that we haven't actually fucked it all up.
Suddenly, save cut file corrupted.
What the hell's happening to the... Oh, right. Oh, I remember. Ian is a... Oh, I just literally looked on the thing and I saw that there was a thing called Ian floating around and I realised what it is. Oh, wait. Ian is following Righty J.
Oh.
That's, awkward. Oh, as yeah.
LKDK.
So we've got Dave 45101 there. And him being orbited by Hannah. Did we say we're going to give Dave another moon or should we leave him with just the one?
I think we should just leave him with Hannah.
Okay.
It was always on his mind.
So now I've got an idea to do something a bit weird. What I'm going to do is move away from this bit of the system. I'm going to put another two stars in.
Okay.
I'm going to get two small dwarf stars, and they're going to be called Fear and Otto. And they're going to be a binary star system.
Nice. Binary suns. Yes.
I need to find two small ones, though. Like, they haven't got too much mass.
When you get around to making another planet, tell me I have an idea for it.
Okay, hold on. Right, so if I put that there and that there, we have two stars orbiting another star, basically.
Nice.
So, we're going to call this one Theo. And we're going to call this one Otto.
Otto.
Now let's speed up time and just see how the two actually work around each other.
Suddenly.
Well, to be fair, they're not exactly... They're not very binary, to be honest.
Hmm.
They just sort of exist. I mean, like, the Allen system is a lot better.
Yeah.
Like, I've just gone back to it and this system is... What the hell's going on? Oh, yeah. Because those two stars out there, they're linked to Alan for some reason. Like, they orbit Alan. I'm not even sure why. Oh, wait, I know why. Because Alan has a bigger mass than them two, I think. Oh, no. They've got mass. Okay, so I've got a plan then. So we're going to fuck about with Into. So let's get a random exoplanet.
Oh.
I want to try and get a planet that goes between the two. Hmm. Okay, there we go.
Fuck's sake.
And we're going to call this planet Soma.
Alright.
Because them two are always fighting over Soma, aren't they?
That is true. And which side of the shed they get?
But the thing is, we're going to make this planet absolutely gigantic, Chris. Like, compared to the two of them. Oh, God. Okay. Okay, never mind. I'm glad we saved, because we accidentally made it so... We made it so big that it became a supernova.
You
what? Quick! Load! Load!
Load, you bastard!
Load!
Tom?
I'm going to leave the Allen system well alone, I think, because I like the Allen system as it is. Actually, no, I'm just going to add a few more bits to it then. Instead of doing the binary system, I think we'll just make a planet called Soma with two moons called Fear and Otto.
That works.
Okay. Anyway, you were going to say something, Mr. Pim?
I was going to say, while you make that, entertain the viewers while I go put this ice cream back into the freezer.
I can entertain my own viewers, dude.
I know you can.
Suddenly.
That's what I'm telling you to.
Suddenly, all of them are just like, what?
Yeah, exactly. Hang on. Be right back.
Okay.
And if you chat shit, I'll see you in the playback.
You know.
Be right back.
So, yeah. While Chris is gone, we're going to build the planet Soma. We're not going to make it as big as we did last time. Let's make it about 2 times bigger than this. Make it a bit bigger. A little bit bigger. Right, there we go. We've got a big planet out here on the outskirts of the system called Soma. What's it made of? And can we change the colour? We can't change the colour. Composition. Made mostly of hydrogen. We'll add some more water as well. I want to add a bit of solid to the middle of it. I want to change its rotation period. Not its rotation period. Its orbital period. No. Rotation period is like 76 days. That'll do. So we're gonna have two moons. A random moon. Well, as Theo's older, we're gonna have him as being the first of the moons. So we have Theo the moon, hooray! And we're gonna have no we're gonna have a little bit of water actually. Or should we have it as being a barren, rocky place? Ooh. Maybe. I'll ask Chris what he thinks when he gets back. Chris, what do you think? He's dead. He's dead, Jim.
You fat bastard.
Chris, do you think Theo should have some water on it?
Well, he...
He's a
Wait,
steam
which
engine.
One is the, which one is the one that had the quack thing?
That was Theo.
Exactly, yes. You see, I'm a real fan. I remember things.
No, you're not.
Notice me, senpai. What?
Notice me, senpai. Right, so we've got the planet Soma, which is a gas giant, being orbited at the moment by Theo, so we're going to add another smaller moon in called Otto. And we're going to have Otto be slightly closer to the planet than Theo. I'm having way too much fun in this game, aren't I, Chris?
Well, it is a fun game. It's just that I wish more people watch it, because then they would see stuff like this.
Exactly. Like, you know, I'm building an entire solar system, basically, with fucking Alan at its center.
Well, he is pretty big-headed.
Well, this is very true.
Bollocks, Alan!
Bollocks, Alan!
Looking fucking furious.
So we've got Fear and Otto orbiting the planet Soma. This is ridiculous. Oh, you know what? We need a third moon around this one. Lino.
What? Yes.
Right, so apparently this planet... I want to add some water to this one as well, actually.
Or Lee.
Oh god, I don't want to do that.
Well, you do.
Right, hang on. Actually, oh god, what happens? What is happening to this bloody thing? It just turns into gas. There we go. Right, there we go. We've got Fear and Otto, and now we need to add Lino. We're going to make it a random big... We're going to make it a big moon. And it orbits further out than the other two. Because obviously... Ah. Give me that. You know what? This would have been better if I'd have actually like thought about this for names of planets, because then I could have had like the center planet could have just been called Dark Railway or something, or Dark, right? Yeah. And you could have had the planets like being named places, like Woolchurch could have had Abomination orbiting it, and Brian.
You could have that. You could have the Dark Railway solar system.
Yeah, I could do one. I mean, this is essentially going to be it, I think. I want to make. What am I doing with Lino, the planet? The moon even. Well, Lino looked quite clean.
Fuck, I wouldn't want to see Mirkum as a planet.
Oh, jeez, can you imagine how big that would be?
And how many moons it'd have.
Oh, Jesus, don't.
and then you'd have one called Mirkum, one called Industrial Estate, and then you'd have a moon called 257 that switches between orbits.
Switching between orbits?
Yeah, because apparently it can fucking fly. And I just got banned, didn't I?
No.
Oh.
Well, that's why that wasn't working. Right, there we go. We have the moon Lino orbiting the planet Soma. I'm enjoying this an awful lot more than I should be.
It's a good game-ish.
It's just too bad the simulation doesn't speed up to the extent you want it to sometimes.
Yeah.
Because, like, when I speed it up, sometimes it just decides it's going to do a derp and not work.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this. We have our nice little solar system with Soma, Rasma 6803, Day 45101, F44422, Ian, and Righty J. Should we go check on Ian?
Yeah.
How is our little Ian doing? He is... He's just screaming through space. So yeah, we'll leave him to it, shall we? Oh no! Please tell me that their orbit don't intersect in any way. I don't think they do. No, I don't think they do.
Greendale was shit.
Oh, I'm gonna click on Alan so I can save this, because I'm gonna save this now. Because what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna play crash it up a little bit. Do you know how?
Oh no, how?
We are gonna introduce another star.
Tom, what are you doing?
And it's gonna be a really, really fucking big star as well.
It's gonna be Dash Star.
It's gonna be Beetlejuice.
Holy shit, that's massive.
Right, do you want to see how much... Oh god, Chris, we're about to literally fuck shit up here.
God damn it, Tom.
Goodbye! Oh my fucking Christ, look how big that is.
I would, but I have no eyes.
Oh my god, dude, we've literally just like... Oh god, Alan, poor Alan. Right, Alan, where's Dave? I want to check Dave. Is Dave okay? Is my Dave okay?
Suddenly Dave was dead.
Let's see. Oh god, no. By introducing Beetlejuice, Dave's... Wait, what is Dave's temperature? Dave's surfing temperature got up to 266 degrees.
Well, he turned so hot because he was sharing dating to Anna.
Wait, hang on, I've got the perfect name for this star.
Is it Leander?
No!
What is
bigger and more important than anything Alan could ever think of? Mr. Dark. So you got this giant star looking on at this little system of engines over there, just like, I'm going to eat all of you.
It's like, why aren't you lazy shits working? Sorry, Mr.
I wonder if we can speed up, how far we can speed up the simulation. Yes. I wanted to see whether the entire system would start getting sucked into, or sucked off, even, to Mr. Dark.
Ooh.
Well, to be fair, like, I'm not going to save this now because, like, you know. But I think, in fairness, what we've done here, we've kept the main integrity of our system.
Oh.
You know why the simulation doesn't work? It's because,
Wait, shit, Tom.
What?
You know when the actual thing that isn't messed up?
Yeah.
You need to add one more planet.
What's that?
Just make one and I'll tell you the name.
Hang on. Let me just edit this because I want to move... To screw the simulation up a bit more.
Yeah.
I'm going to move the planet... I'm going to move the sun, Mr. Dark, closer to my system to see what it does. Right, so what's going to happen now? Well...
Beetle, oh shit.
Jesus, can you imagine being on the... Well, oh god, Righty J. Oh no, Righty J! Oh, it's burning up.
Oh, shit.
Its surfing temperature is 1,320 degrees.
Meanwhile, back at Rasmus.
Oh, wait, hang on. What's happened to... What was it... Oh, not Titan is 1,180 degrees.
Wow.
Beta Wax is floating away from it, I think. It's being sucked in now. But Betawax is at 1,270. Oh my god, it's just basically a ball of lava at this point. Yeah, everything in... Oh god, yeah, they're being pulled in. What's that? Oh, Ian! Our mate Ian. How's our mate Ian doing? Yeah, Chris?
Yeah.
He's nothing more than... he's at 1,100 degrees Celsius.
Gee.
And his entire surface is just melting.
Oops.
He's losing... he's getting heavier. Not heavier. Oh god, mate. Oh god, what have we done? Rasmus, what's happened to you? You're 800 degrees.
Damn it. Tom.
Hey, up.
Again, it's the viewers. I need to get food.
Okay. Well, hang on. Oh no, Chris, Phil's gone.
I'm here.
No, don't worry. Actually, I thought Phil had gone, but he's fine.
Alright, good. Go back.
Well, I say he's fine. He's broken into little bits, I think. Oh god, he's 800 degrees. How's Colin doing? Colin's at 800. Colin's at. Oh my god, that is such a bizarre looking planet. So they're being sucked in. What is going on over there? Oh, that's Soma. Soma is still warm but relatively unscathed, and the moon's still going round and round. Although Lino is starting to trail behind. Oh, right, because it's in a wider orbit, that's why. What's happening over here? What planets haven't we looked at yet? Oh, hang on. Here we go. F, found a 4F. 911 degrees. Oh god, yeah, that's ruined. Has Whitey J been sucked in yet? I think it has. And Ian. Oh no! Oh bless. Oh no, is that Ian there? Yeah, Ian is. God, yeah, that is getting sucked off quite badly. Wait, did I just see what I think I saw? No, I think we've lost Whitey J. Dave, how's Dave doing? Oh no, he's burning up. Oh god. It's just like the watching the death of all things. God, this video has been nearly an hour long. I think I have to give it quits there. Well, as we watch, oh, Chris, you're back. Just to let you know that we're finishing here, because I've been doing it for nearly an hour now, and yeah.
Chris is back.
We lost Righty J to Mr. Dark. I think Ian's just succumbed. No, Ian's all right at the moment, but Dave is getting very close.
Uh-oh.
I'm just watching as their temper. Oh, even Alan is being sucked in as well.
Uh-oh.
So what should we just leave it there, or should we wait and see if we can quickly see if
Well, you could leave it there, but I still want to add that one planet.
It doesn't matter now. I'm destroyed. Well, I'm not. I'm saving it, but it's being destroyed as we speak. Like literally, Mr. Dark is literally sucking everything in.
All right, we'll see if you get this, Tom.
Yeah.
This is what I was gonna call the planet, right?
Go on.
Wait, hang on. S R. G-U-L.
S-R-G-U-L? And that
S-R-D-G, S-R-G-U-L.
Yeah.
63449.
That's supposed to be some reference to Callum, isn't it? Sergal.
Yes.
What was the 4-6, whatever it was, what was the number?
63449, that's Gerald. 6.
Oh, okay. I might add that next time. Oh, God. Yeah, Dave is. Oh god, and temperature is increasing. Oh god, yeah, he's melting now.
Oops.
Dude, this star is literally. Oh my god, I can. Oh god, you know what? Actually, we are going to have to sit around and watch this, because I'm pretty sure that when Alan hits that, it's going to go supernova. God. Yeah, the planet Dave has literally just been eaten. And we're about to watch Alan get eaten as well by a star. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to step back, because it could become a supernova.
Uh-oh.
Yep, it was a supernova. Holy shit, everything gone. Oh my freaking Christ. You will see this on the video, Chris. But yeah. Jesus, that is one massive quasar explosion there. I think that's pretty much the place to leave this video then.
Well, it is.
Well, I hope everyone enjoyed watching me build a universe and then destroy it by putting a gigantic fucking star in there. Oh, you know what I need to call a star?
What?
Morning star.
Hey.
Or load star, even. Anyway, as we watch this magnificent explosion destroy everything we have been building today. In fact, oh wait, yeah, it's all just, yeah, everything's gone. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, and we'll do some more of these Universe Sandbox videos at some point. So, yeah. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Goodbye.
Bye.